This video will cover how to create approximate channel data for use in 2D hydraulic models. Terrain data used for 2D models is often a combination of different data types. LiDAR is the most common terrain data type available for large portions of the U.S. Most LiDAR data does not include data points below the water surface, except along some coastal areas. Bathymetric data is not readily available for most inland waterways, and often project constraints may limit the amount of data that can be collected for a project. It is best practice to collect detailed bathymetric data in the area of interest and develop approximate data for channels within the project area where detailed hydraulics are not required. Detailed hydraulic results are typically not needed away from a bridge. However, without channel data, the distribution and conveyance of water upstream and downstream of a bridge will not be sufficiently represented and may impact hydraulic results near the bridge. The purpose of creating approximate channel data is to better represent the conveyance area in the channel at locations where accurate survey data does not exist. If the discharge in the channel during the LiDAR survey was insignificant compared to what will be analyzed during the modeling, then approximate channel data is not necessary. For example, if the flow during the LiDAR survey was 50 CFS and the flows being modeled will be 5 to 10,000 CFS, then approximate channel data is not necessary. Three approaches are most commonly used to create approximate channel bathymetry. The first option is to develop an average channel section based on channel data from multiple surveyed cross sections. For instance, if detailed survey data exists near a bridge, an average channel cross-section could be developed and used as a template for other channel locations within the model domain where no survey data exists. The second option is to develop an approximate trapezoidal channel section representing the channel's conveyance capacity developed from the discharge in the channel at the time of the topographic survey and the approximate slope of the channel. The hydraulic toolbox or similar tools can help determine approximate channel areas. The third option involves creating an approximated channel centerline at a defined offset from the water surface based on the topographic survey. All three methods provide an approximate representation of the hydraulic capacity of the channel not represented by the topographic data. A few options exist for creating approximate channel data in SMS. If a representative section is developed from channel survey data, the stamping tool in SMS can be used to create an averaged cross-section along a user-defined centerline. More information about feature stamping can be found on the SMS wiki page. If representing the channel with approximate breaklines, there are two options depending on how the LiDAR data was processed along the channel. Some LiDAR surfaces have hydro-enforced breaklines that approximate the water surface at the time of the survey. If the LiDAR data does not have hydro-enforced breaklines, the channel area will appear choppy due to the irregular triangulation that occurs along the channel. If hydro-enforced breaklines were used, arcs can be created in SMS and assigned the elevations to them from the LiDAR surface along the channel. These lines can then be transformed vertically a specified amount to create a single Thalweg line or toe of channel lines that will represent the approximate channel data. If hydro-enforced breaklines were not used to create the LiDAR surface, approximate channel lines will need to be assigned elevations manually by adjusting node and vertex elevation values. After creating the approximate channel lines, the LiDAR data, approximate channel lines, and any other survey data can be combined into a single surface. See the merging terrain data video for more information. Creating approximate channel data for 2D models is a common practice and provides improved results when collecting additional data is not feasible. You can download a summary one-pager with links to additional resources here.